Hello everyone, I'm Meenu Jain. Here in this video, I would like to discuss about sludge, which is generated from wastewater treatment processes, and sludge dewatering, or removal of water from slurry followed by slurry into dry solid form or slurry to dry biosolid cake formation. Sludge dewatering in wastewater treatment plant is a physical unit operation used to reduce the moisture content of sludge and biosolids. It is necessary for reducing the volume resulting less disposal commute cost. Dewatered sludge is easier to handle than a thickened or liquid sludge. If sludge is using for incineration, then dewatering is necessary for increasing the calorific value. For providing odorless and non-putrescible biosolids, dewatering is necessary. And dewatering also helps in reducing leachate production during landfilling. The selection of dewatering device is determined by type of sludge, characteristic of product and space available. For separating liquid of different density, thickening slurry or removing solids, the centrifugation process is used. Filtration, squeezing, capillary action and centrifugal separation followed by compaction is a general physical process used in sludge dewatering process. Some dewatering equipments are solid bowl centrifuge, belt filter press, plate and frame filter press, drying bed and sludge lagoon. During industrial process of wastewater treatment, huge quantity of sludge is produced. Sludge need to be disposed of or further treatment. One of the treatment method available is thickening the sludge by using solid bowl centrifuge. While prior sludge have the concentration around 0.5 to 1% of dry solids after thickening process, it will come up to 5 to 6% of dry solids. This process reduces the waste of activated sludge volume by more than 80% as well as minimizing the sludge amount for digestion by 30 to 40%. Drying bed and lagoon are used generally for smaller plant where land availability is not an issue. Now comes to the first type of sludge dewatering equipment, which is solid bowl centrifuge. There is two type of centrifuges are used, countercurrent and co-current. The main difference in the designing of these centrifuges is the location of sludge feed port, removal of centrate and internal flow pattern of the liquid and solid phase. Here, sludge is fed at constant flow rate from one end of solid bowl where it separates into a dense cake containing the solids and dilute stream called centrate. The centrate contains fine solid particles in filtrate liquid or dilute stream or in centrate. Dense cake and in dilute stream of the centrate then collected in the different hopper or disposed of as per the requirement and facility available. Solid bowl centrifuge is a type of centrifuge that uses the principle of sedimentation. A centrifuge used to separate a mixture that consists of two substances with different density by using that centrifugal force resulting from continuous rotation. There are three design types of solid bowl centrifuges are currently available in the market, which are conical, cylindrical and conical cylindrical. Advantages of solid bowl centrifuges are rapid startup and shutdown, relatively simple installations, its compact design and functions automatically with minimum monitoring and control units. It's flexible use for both thickening and dewatering process, and it needs relatively low polymer quantity compared to other types except basket centrifuge. This device could handle large liquid capacity and able to deal with more concentrated slurry, and it produces more dry solids and has better solids retention. But it has some disadvantages also, which are less surface area available for clarification compared to disc stack. This may generate heat and that could damage the thermosensitive products. It requires high maintenance, especially for scroll wear part. Thus, it is recommended to have hard surface and abrasion protector. Sometimes, it also produces unwanted noise and occasionally produces vibration that disturbs electronic control and structural components. It needs high power consumption, and it requires pre-testing for selecting optimum machine setting before starting the normal service. There are So many process variables affects the centrifuge performance. These process variables are sludge cake solid and total suspended solid recovery, feed flow rate, rotational speed of shaft, differential speed of scroll, depth of settling zone, and physicochemical properties of suspended solids and suspended liquids. Major operational difficulties is disposal of centrate because of the relatively high in suspended and non-settleable solids. For troubleshooting the operational difficulties, increased residence time and chemical conditioning method can be used to control the fine solid discharge and to increase the capture. Solids capture may increase from a range of 50 to 80% to a range of 80 to 90% by longer residence time and chemical conditioning. Centrifuge installation area is less than the other dewatering device of equal capacity, and initial cost is also lower. During installation, sturdy foundation and soundproofing is must because of the vibration and noise resulted from centrifuge operation. And adequate power source is also required for motor and rotation of the centrifuge. Next, sludge dewatering equipment is belt filter press, as shown in the figure. Belt filter press was first introduced in United States in early 1970s and become one of the predominant sludge dewatering device, and it has proved to be effective for almost all type of municipal wastewater sludge and biosolids. This device is a continuous phase dewatering device that uses the principle of chemical conditioning, gravity drainage and mechanical applied pressure to dewater sludge. Here, conditioned sludge is first introduced on the gravity drainage section where it is allowed to thicken. Here, majority of free water is removed from sludge by gravity, followed by gravity drainage. Pressure is applied in low pressure section where the sludge is squeezed between the opposing porous cloth belts. The final dewatered sludge cake is removed from the belt by scraper blades and get collected in sludge hopper, and concentrate is collected in another hopper. Now comes to the design consideration and process performance of belt filter press. These are available in metric size from 0.5 to 3.5 meter in belt width. The most common size used for municipal sludge application is 2 meter. Sludge loading rate vary from 90 to 680 kg per meter per hour depending on the sludge type and feed concentration. Hydraulic throughput based on the belt width ranges from 1.6 to 6.3 liter per meter per second. And safety considerations in design should include adequate ventilation to remove hydrogen sulfide and other gases, and equipment guards to prevent loose clothing from being caught between the rollers. Many variables like sludge characteristic, method and type of chemical conditioning, pressure developed, machine configuration including gravity drainage, belt porosity, belt speed and belt width, these all variables affect the performance of belt filter press. Next sludge dewatering unit operation is filter press. In filter press, dewatering is achieved by forcing the water from the sludge under high pressure. Chemically conditioned sludge is pumped into the space between the plates, and pressure of 690 to 1550 kN per square meter is applied and maintained for 1 to 3 hours. Forcing the liquid through the filter cloth and plate outlet port, the plates are then separated and sludge is removed. Sludge cake thickness varies about 25 to 38 mm and moisture content varies from 48 to 70% and filtration cycle varies from 2 to 5 hours. In this equipment, high concentration of cake solid can be achieved with good filtrate quality and high solid capture. But mechanical complexity, high chemical cost, high labor cost and limitation on filter cloth life is a main disadvantage of filter presses. The hydraulic filter press can also be divided into chamber filter press and plate and frame filter press. The main difference in both filter presses is filter plates. In plate and frame filter press, the chamber are formed by plate and frames placed on the filter press beam in turn. Usually, filtering pressure it can bear it less than 0.6 megapascal. Also, it is generally used for slurries, has little solid particles, and it is more suitable for fine particles filtering than a chamber type filter press. By adding a filter paper on the back of the filter cloth will make the filtering precision less than 1 micrometer. And in chamber filter press, the chamber are formed by same plate only. The chamber type filter plates are more thick than plate and frame type filter plates. The feeding hole is at the center of the filter plate. Chamber type filter press is ideal equipment for high content sludge such as wastewater treatment, mining, coal washing, etc. It has the disadvantage of quick filtering speed, easy filter cake discharge, high filtering pressure, drier filter cake, and longer lifetime of plates. This makes it more widely used and more easy to add the function of auto pulling plates. Both plate and frame filter press and chamber filter press have two ways of filtrate flow. One is so called open delivery presses, where the filtrate from each individual filter press plates flow into an open channel, and the other is closed delivery filter presses, where filtrate is discharged into closed channel, for example passing through the interior of filter press. To get avoid of corrosion in acid and alkali environment, we can add fiberglass or stainless steel coating for filter press. As discussed, plate and frame filter press contains series of rectangular plates, vertical position frame with fixed and movable heads. Filter cloth is fitted on each plates. The plate and frame are held together with sufficient force to seal them to withstand the pressure applied during the filtration process. Hydraulic rams or powered screws are used to hold the plates together. Some design consideration of filter presses are: fill time takes 10 to 15 minutes. Initial dewatering pressure is used as 690 to 860 kN per meter square, and final compression pressure is applied from 1380 to 2070 kN per meter square. And operational considerations are adequate ventilation in dewatering room, high pressure washing system, acid wash recirculation system to remove calcium scaling when lime is used, and equipment to facilitate removal and maintenance of plates. Next sludge dewatering equipment is sludge drying bed. Sludge drying beds are typically used to dewater digested biosolids and settled sludge from plant using extended aeration activated sludge treatment process without pre-thickening. The principal advantages of drying bed are low cost, less attention required, and high solids content in dried product. And main disadvantages are large space required, effect of climate changes on drying characteristics, labor intensive for sludge removal, and insect and potential odors. Five types of sludge drying bed are generally used in water and wastewater treatment plants, in which first is conventional sand drying bed, next is paved drying bed, artificial media drying beds, vacuum assisted drying beds, and solar drying beds. And last type of sludge dewatering equipment is drying lagoon. It may be used as substitute for drying beds for dewatering the digested sludge. Biosolids depth in sludge lagoon usually ranges from 0.75 to 1.25 meter. Evaporation is the prime mechanism for dewatering. Biosolids are removed mechanically, usually at solid content of 25 to 30%. The cycle time for lagoon varies from several months to several years. Typically, biosolids are pumped to the lagoon for 18 months and then lagoon is rested for 6 months. Solid loading criteria ranges from 36 to 39 kg per meter cube per year of lagoon capacity. And even in very small plant, minimum of 2 cells is essential to ensure the availability of storage space during cleaning, maintenance, and emergency conditions. Lagoons are not suitable for dewatering untreated sludge, limited sludge, or sludge with high strength supernatant because of their odor and nuisance potential. The performance of lagoons is also affected by climate change, like in conventional sludge drying beds. These are the references of this video. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please like, subscribe, and feel free to comment for any clarification and doubts. Thank you.